Tear dropping.
Tear dropping. That one. And?
Whipping.
Whipping.
Which?
Whipping. Whipping. Okay, no, we haven't dropped the base. Great on you for that. Okay. So they're all principles of how we develop power and how we remove surface strikes to get different ideas and different reactions from the body and so on, okay? But there are other things that we build in, as we've covered these before, but we'll recap very quickly just to get us moving, and then we'll start going up some actual technique as well. Okay? So, let's say, for example, we're going to cover as again, misdirection or flashing if you want. He grabs, and I go. I'm going to tell him what's happening, okay? So, important part of it is misdirection, first off, or flashing, as we like to call it. Okay? So basically what happens is, as he's grabbing, I want to mess with his loom reflex. Okay? Where the head jumps back because the eyes run correct. Okay? Doesn't have to hit him, it just has to make him uncomfortable. When I come to here then, that makes this happen, and I'm here already. Okay? Realistically, I'm here already. Okay? And this all ties together. Now we break this down. We'll cover base aggression as an example of this. But just to be clear, this could fit to untoubling death, which we have on our yellow belt jiu-jitsu as well. All of these type of techniques where I make Tony feel very uncomfortable. Okay? So as he grabs, first things first, he's going to pull me forwards. If he's got full mind behind that, I'm in trouble. So I want him to stutter for a second, okay? So as he goes, this gives me this shot here. This is a hammer shot to the jaw, okay? I'm going to bring this down, hit an elbow, hit an elbow. If you really want to feck with him, flash across him again. So as you hit, you could actually send that back into the face again if you really wanted. Now granted, we all know this is where we're going from now on, okay? But for the purpose of this, we stay where we are. We hit one, down, hit, elbow, elbow. So step, hook, okay? We'll break it down to slowest motion. Step, hook, hit, okay? Step, hook, hit, drop, okay? Step, hook, hit, drop, elbow, and elbow. I don't want to go from the full sequence again for that last move. Bang, from here, check that off at the end just to make sure he's gone, okay? So that's mace aggression. But the purpose of this is the flash is important, okay? The intent is also important here. So, if he just kind of leaves his hands lazily there, my technique will function whatever way I want it to function, or not at all. Okay? So, if he's grabbing me and he's pulling, it's up to me to make this happen. And this kind of relates to what we were talking about earlier on. This idea as well. Make him panic, take something away from him, take it away quickly. Okay? But build up this motion. Okay? And then shorten. Everything hits all of them, it's going through. Okay? Cool, go.
So, watch their mouth, please. Cunt.
Okay. All good? Thanks. The technique overall is the medium, not the message. Okay? So bear that in mind. There's a lot in techniques, and realistically, you can highlight any one thing and make it the theme of the technique for the night. Okay? It just saves us, rather than standing here, kind of going, okay, Tommy's going to put his hands out, and I'm going to go flash, grab, flash, hit. Flash, flash, clear, flash, flash, hit, bang, all this type of stuff, you know? It gets more exciting when we start adding stuff in, because then you start seeing it in a little bit more of a practical way, okay? But what you'll notice is, well, I'm not going to you here. Flash, flash, flash. This is literally me going, one, from here. The only thing that has any kind of gusto to it, if you like, is that, okay? Which brings me to another point. It should be very, very discreet until the point that it contacts it. Okay, or pass a poem if you like. Alright? So this shouldn't be me basically, we'll go back to what we were doing. This shouldn't be me going this way to Tony, because realistically putting this in front of his face, he goes, oh look, it fits. And then he disengages. Okay? He knows something's up the second I go to him here. You know what I mean? He might get more aggressive, he might not. He might just back away and take a different action. Alright? From here, you see the difference in reaction. So you've got this. Okay, both delivered with the same intent, everything. Okay, and he didn't know which one was coming. Same thing again, that gives us our position here, this is our position here, this is our position here, any of these things here, okay? Everyone clear on what we're saying? So, yes, this is the intent. Now, so technique shouldn't become the be-all and end-all of this, alright? Okay, so on that note, I'm not going to cover too much on flashing tonight because obviously it's very clear. But one thing that you will notice, however, is it's almost like a parry. You know, for people who don't like parries, like it's very, very, very similar to a parry or something. Okay? Almost. Not really, but almost. Okay? So, basically it travels the same line as a parry outside the sight point here. Okay? Even better if there's an arm in the way, because, well, you can't see much more than that either way. But it's here, it still happens the same way. Okay? Like we said, that can also be a flash, but not this. Alright? Okay. So, I'm going to go to the blade sword, and I'm going to play with something just for the fun of it. Because I can. Alright. So, he's going to punch, I'm going to block, I'm going to kick him, I'm going to chop. Now, everyone engages this hand, right? Yeah? We're trying to make you smart enough to think you don't have to stand there and take it, and there's always a reason why you could have your hand there or anything else. Realistically, no, it probably isn't going to be there if I kick you in the stones anyway, and the target's going to be there. However, if I fluff that, now something else is. So he's grabbing. This can happen. And this is why we have so many techniques with so many options. Okay? For one, we could come here with roll over. Okay? That's one option. Okay? Or simply we can pluck and we can dip. Okay? So we're going to go with pluck and dip for now and then see how far we can go. Okay. So, pluck, kick, strike. So this is delayed sword as you know. Okay? Wow. From here, pluck. As I do this, and everyone sees the rear crossover that we always have everywhere. Okay, so again, block, kick, hit. Alright? So let's presume the kick has failed. Okay? Let's say we're too close. He actually gets a little bit more depth, so he gets this. Maybe all he can do is go for this, and he's got a hand there. So from here, look, straight through. As I strike through, we hit. Move to the other side. Okay? Also, bear in mind, once I hit this, probably going to go forward anyway, so reaching back for me, not the least, not the most of the worries at this point anyway, okay? Everyone got that? Yeah? Okay, fill that up and then we'll add to this. Fail. Chuck. Okay? Let's make it a legitimate fail, alright? Let's be realistic about this. I block him. Maybe he can step a little forward. Mine's not really a legitimate target at this point, okay? Could kick him in the outside of the knee. Again, range might be an issue for me, might be too close, maybe too far in. So from here, you could legitimately feed in. If he's doing all that motion or crap, I don't know. But from here, grab. Okay, and one thing we noted about this is grab. If he's meaty, that's not going to happen. Okay? So what you do is bring the grab in to you. So you need this. This to this. Slight turn, not this big kind of hey! Just from here, flip, pop. Okay? All good? Kind of relates to something I show in Five Swords. If I prep this, I don't prep this like this to hit him this way, I prep like this. I'm gonna do extra shots. To hit him like this. So that'll give the full rotation and get everything set up. Likewise, rotate, preps it, and it's turned against itself, and then it fires in from there. Okay? So, way of breaking the grab, way of also getting more power into the in a short distance, okay? Definitely. From here, pop through. Well, as we pop through, throw it, okay? Now, from here, stand up. Yep. I'm going to drive back on the leg. For those who have grasp of death, you could essentially do this. Okay? It's called shape recognition. You're in a place, use it. Okay? Personally, I like smack on the back of the skull here.
One to me after 2 years of training.
Yeah. From here, drive, take him down to this position, hit a knee, okay? Now, this knee may be restricted, it may not get to his head, it may just hit a shoulder, but that's fine. Because once I hit that, I can drive that back down again and take him down. Notice how I did that slowly, without blowing his kneecap out, okay? So, once we hit through, this drops. There's our position here. From here, drive, take him down. Okay? So, knee, boom, up and under, okay? And drive back. Okay? If he doesn't go away on this one, now you can be a shit. And do that. The trick to the last part is not dragging him, because if I drag him, he's just going to come along with me and follow me. So when I take him down, and I hit this knee, this is going down. Nice and easy on the elbow, because you can't hyperextend at this point as well, okay? So when I push, when I step, I drop with my stance, almost like dropping base, okay? And then from here, down. So everything goes down on that, that way you can't trail me. Everyone clear on that? One more time? Okay. So, we got the starts. So block from here. There's your check here. Grab, pop through. As we pop through, drop back, okay? From here, come over, down, knee. Drive, drop. Step back here. Okay? This is just getting your footwork moving in, back out, up, down, everything working together now. Make sense? Okay, off we go.
Turn your head to the side when you hit the floor.
It helps.
We'll do it with him.
Okay? So, he feeds clock or fire if he stops it, okay? Or he just puts a hand there, whatever. Okay, from here, I grab, if he's got fingers open. Okay, we could, but we won't. So, we chop, we grab, okay? As we turn and we pull, we said this, it's not going to be this big kind of. It should be kind of subtle enough to make this all happen at once. Almost like a quick hand change up. Alright?
It's amazing,
isn't it?
Truly, this man is the son of God.
That was a terrible John Wayne accent. Okay, so, switch. From here, you won't be able to pull out with the twist. Okay? You notice that what I'm doing is my glove, I get to here. But overall, what we tend to do is my glove, the open. That's fine, I'm matching his line. If I had something else where I could move him, pick him up, do something else, and as we all know how to do art. Okay? But what we're looking at this point is, once I pluck and I hit, okay? I drop, drop the twist. Now, point of the twist is, stance that allows you to change direction quite easily. So we know I'm going back this way. If I rotate my hips this way, towards Keith, now I'm on the line to drive back for this. When you take the right side back, that's very labored, and I'm already planted on a very kind of rigid position, I guess. Here, I could easily start the end of my game and kind of whip back and all this type of stuff. And we rotate, throw it back. Okay? So, what you're going to do is get a very quick kind of circular motion into a linear motion. Okay? Make sense? Everyone alright with that so far? Now, again, I'm just using my arm here for this one, but you can use that strike that we covered a second ago as well. But to relate it to something on a basic level, you can use this as well. Alright, make sense? Okay, so bear that in mind with your twist stances. That's someone quite right to point it out. So from here, someone quite right to point it out. I move to here. Once I get into position here, my twist is actually what gets me into position. From here then, body drop. Okay? This basic footwork kind of fits in to a lot of our stuff. Almost like, I don't know, it's all part of the same thing, really, isn't it? So the twist stance is prevalent everywhere when we move. Once we move in, and we want to change direction very quickly, or move him around us very quickly, you'll probably find there's a twist stance getting you there. So it's important that we isolate it, take it out, and we say, this is how we move. As a group, this is how we move. Or how we should move, or aim to move. Okay? Make sense? So I want you to make sure that the twist stance is happening. So once more straight. One, stop to pulls, drop from here. That's how quick that could be if you really want it to be. Like I said, it's not quite a reap, as we would call it, or a hawk, as others would call it. When we drive, this is literally me just shooting my line, interrupting his line and his base, and dropping my heel, projecting through that. So it's slightly more ballistic in a sense. Okay? Everyone clear on that? All good? So try to work clearly on that twist stance, make sure it's in there. Drive it into your head now, because we're going to use it over and over and over. I promise. Okay? Sweet. Check when we drop. There should be not much space between my knees. Okay? So, I can explain to some people, if I was to drop into a twist stance from here, my right foot would point towards 3, my left foot would drop back to 6. My toe, or my toes, rather, on the left foot, will basically be bearing most of the weight for that leg, okay? If I change direction, which in this case, this will allow me to change towards this direction, or turn my back towards this direction, the right foot now switches to the ball of the foot as a weight bearing, okay? Sorry, the main weight bearing leg is the left, but the toes are bearing the weight from the right foot, and So how I do that is I change, and then you can switch these kind of motions in. Once you build that up, once you feel that kind of moment of, yeah, I feel sprung loaded and ready to go, as soon as I rotate, everything goes out a lot quicker. But if you're in this position, then everything's a lot more labored, and realistically you don't have a base under you. And as we all know, if we don't have a good base under us, none of this stuff is going to work. So, another thing to know from this is, we talked about our roundhouse kick earlier on. So, when we did our roundhouse off the back leg, boom, that was fine, we had all that distance, okay? When we did our roundhouse off the front leg, we then have to take a short generate and get everything in, yeah? Okay, likewise, you can do the same with this. Everyone's seen the kind of leaping, squat kick, jumping, side kick, blah, 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 kicking with your arse, wheel kick or whatever, okay? From here, when I move, this would be the big step to give me all that power. Let's say I wanted to generate in short distance, so maybe I fed from here. Okay? So from there as I go, that might give me the generation. Granted, this is not legitimate, but it's illustrating a point. From here, if I fed this, okay, rather than going kind of and then 10 steps forward, what if I only wanted to kind of hit him where he stands? So I kind of bring the foot up to here. From here now, I don't have to take that big kind of leap through. As I go from here, I kick, and I guarantee you, you'll get a good hit. Okay? You should at least feel something coming off it, if not enough to kind of move it. Okay? So, this is ultimately what we're looking to do. Remember what we said, we start off really, really big, we can pack it down really, really small. Okay? It's very difficult to do it the other way around, because when you're really, really small, it's very hard to get back out of there. Okay? So we do generate, we do move, we do set up with the idea to get this motion. However, what I will say is it takes time to get this. So we should not be racing to get here. We should be taking our time and making sure we get it right all the way from the start. So when you see some people, namely people with very dark colours around their waist, doing things like these extra shuffle motions, I can guarantee you they're not short it down to the point where you think they're hopping in on this type of stuff. Really not happening that way. The difference is they've taken a gross motion and made it a fine motion, which gives you the same idea. But a lot faster, obviously. Okay? So, bear that in mind. Tony was saying to somebody when we were walking around, this shouldn't be me going. Alright? What this should be is, I get it right, as we said already, boom. Doesn't matter if this takes forever. It's the delivery of each shot should be sharp. Not total elapsed time. That's not what we're looking for, okay? If this is sharp, that'll be sharp. If this is sharp, that'll be sharp, okay? Pop through, through here, drive down, okay? This is what we're looking for. We're not looking for not to 60. Technique. We're looking for 0 to 60 each move, but delivered correctly. Okay? So from here, rather than that's crap, I can guarantee. Alright? Okay. So try to take it back down to basic. Make everything delivered correctly. Because you're not going to use them all in one go. You'll use one at a time in different sequences. So get everything right. Then we can play around with it more. Okay? All good? Couple more times on that and we'll move on. Yes. Okay? Yeah? Line ends. Circle begins. Circle ends. Line begins. So I'm not making this thing a big round swing. This is literally, this is terminal point here. Once we get through here, this is terminal point once I open out. From here, line. Clear? Okay. And he should make a nice line as well between his head going that way and his legs going that way. Alright? So bear that rule in mind. Line ends, circle begins. Circle ends, line begins. Thus ends the lesson. Okay? Like I said, if the most important thing you take from that particular setup is, it's that rule we just said. And using the twist stance to prove that. Okay? Like I said, learn it. Use it. We are going to use it over and over. The If we have to keep repeating ourselves, so be it. Okay. Right. So what we're going to cover now is enough of that.